हेलो एवरीवन, अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम बैक टू आवर लेक्चर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एक्ट 2000, दैट इज इट इज़ आल्सो कॉल्ड एज आईटी एक्ट 2000। बेसिकली व्हाई वी यूज दिस इन साइबर क्राइम, इन एवरी क्रिमिनोलॉजी we know there should be a rule. For example, if a person is doing a crime, he must be giving some punishment. So in cyber world, there may be a crime by cyber crime, so it should be in a particular law, in a primary law. So it has been defined by the government of India, that is we have to merge with it in its law. So Information Technology Act will assign you what it is going to provide us. Basically, the Information Technology Act 2000, also known as ITA 2000 or the IT Act 2000, you can say. Now what do you mean by word 2000? That means it has been notified in year 2000, that's why. Okay, let us see again. IT Act 2000 is also known as ITA 2000 or IT Act. Okay, it is an act of Indian Parliament. What it is? It is an act of Indian Parliament. Now what is Indian Parliament? Indian Parliament, the Parliament of India, that is Bharatiya Sansad, is a supreme legislative body. We know we have a supreme legislative body, right? In India, it is the Republic of India, and who is composed of President of India and two houses of Rajya Sabha and one house of Lok Sabha. So this is a Parliament of India which have its power. Okay, so Parliament of India has made this law, it is IT Act, okay, which has been notified in 17 October 2000. It is 17 October 2000 they have given this. So in year 2000 the IT Act has made. It is primary law in India. Okay, it is a primary law in India. It is a primary law in India dealing with cyber crime. How it deals? It deals with cyber crimes and electronic commerce. We are learning a cyber crime, cyber security chapter, and electronic commerce, that is e-commerce, which is there in 12th standard. Okay, I will give short description about both this, but we learn this in a primary law. India is giving a law which will deal with your cyber crime and electronic commerce. Okay, now let us see the Information Technology Act, what it provides. The Act provides legal recognition for transaction carried out by means of electronic data interchange. Let us understand what is given. This Act, whatever IT Act is there, it is used to provide a legal recognition, legal conditions, whatever it may be, for your transactions. Whatever transaction you are going to carry out, transaction means giving and taking. You are doing a business, you are exchanging of goods, transactions, whatever payment mode you are doing, it is in the form of legal recognition, which is going to carry out by means of electronic data interchange, that is EDI. EDI stands for electronic data interchange. That means you are making a transaction in through electronic means, and other means of electronic communication, you can also say it is going to provide us other means of electronic communications also, which is commonly referred to as electronic commerce, that is e-commerce. Now what it is said as, it is also commonly recognized as e-commerce. Now what is e-commerce? Buying and selling of products through online media, that is electronic media. So you can also deal it with online media. Clear? Which involves the use of alternative to paper-based methods. That is, we are going to involve the use of alternatives. We are going to use paperless work. We are going to pass alternatives to paper-based methods of communication and storage of information. That means we are going to avoid your paper-based work and we are going to use online work. It is an alternate method. Okay, we are going to avoid a paper-based method of communication and we are going to directly communicate with internet. And storage of information also, you can say, okay. That is Tunasta, editing, filing of document with the government agencies. And further to amend the Indian Penal Code. What is Indian Penal Code? IPC. Okay. Indian Evidence Act. That means we are going to deal with our government agencies through online mode of transactions. So in this, we are going to amend. We are going to further connect with IPC, that is Indian Penal Code, then Indian Evidence Act 1872. This Indian Evidence Act is giving you an Evidence Act of India in your 1872. The Bankers Book Evidence, these all are the Evidence Acts. Okay, Bankers Evidence Act 1891, Reserve Bank of India Act 1937, and favor matters connected therewith are incidental thereto. There may be another favors. Okay, now we are going to see citation. We are going to write it as Information Technology Act. To some citation means how to write this act. The right act writes in the form of like Information Technology Act, 2000. It is enacted by Parliament of India. Okay, enacted by Parliament of India, and it was enacted in 9th June 2000. When it is enacted, in 9th June 2000. Again, assented to 9th June 2000, and it is signed also in a 9th June 2000. But it was started, it is commenced on 17th October 2000. It's commenced on 17th October 2000, and it was introduced by Pramod Mahajan. It was introduced by Pramod Mahajan, Minister of Communication and Information Technology. Pramod Mahajan was a Minister of Communication and Technology. Information Technology, that time it was introduced. Okay, this was our IT Act. Let us see some features of IT Act now. There are some features of Information Technology Act 2000. Let us see these features one by one. Features of Information Technology Act 2000. All electronic contracts created through secure electronic channel were legally valid. The very first feature they have given is whatever electronic contracts, whatever transaction is going to create, it is securely through electronic channels only. Can you see this? Very first thing. Okay. Legal recognition for digital signature. That means we are going to recognize all the transaction using a digital signature. What is digital signature now? Whatever transaction is going, it is in online mode. Okay. Next, security measures for electronic records and conjointly digital signatures are in place. A procedure for appointment of adjudicating officer for holding inquiries underneath the act is finalized. Here we can find out the adjudicating officers, that is, in place of digital signature, conjointly we are turning with a procedure of appointing an adjudicating officer who is going to hold the finalization of act. Last is your provision for establishing a cyber restrictive appellate judicature underneath the act. That means we are going to establish a cyber security restrictive appellate, which is going to further judicate with handle and all appeals created against the order of the controller or adjudicating officer. It's going to create order against the controller for adjudicating officers only. Okay. So this was our features of IT Act 2000, and this was the Information Technology Act 2000 we have learned today in our lecture. It is very important topic. It may come in your examination. So by heart this, learn this topic very thoroughly. This was the topic of
IT Act.
Indian Parliament has notified IT Act. Okay, we know this a very important topic. It is going to elaborate your jurisdiction dispenses. Detailed signature has been replaced over here. Then it elaborates offenses, penalties and breaches, whatever it may be. It is going to provide us. And the main point, last point is given is here. The Act, IT Act 2000 was amended in 2008 and 2011. That means now the amendment has come of IT Act 2000 in 2008 and 2011. And it includes rules of cyber cafe, cyber security, delivery of services and by service providers, audit of electronic document, etc. These all are the content of the document. So IT Act 2000 amended in 2008 and 2011 also. This was the amendment. Okay. So this was our IT Act 2000. If you have any doubts, please write us comment. We are going to solve this in our college section. Okay, when we meet in the college, we are going to solve all the revision part. We are going to deal with this. Don't worry. Prepare for your examinations. Learn it thoroughly. Okay. Thank you. Love is. Assalamu alaikum.